Hello dear students, welcome to Wisdom Corner. Here I am going to start with our 6th standard, the remaining topics which were remaining to complete the explanation part, like the chapters like the word of a fabric 2.2. So for 6th standard it is a continuing part. Whatever I have explained earlier, it was the starting part of it. Now I will be going to explain word of a fabric chapter. So what do you mean by word of a fabric chapter? So this chapter is all about the fabrics, the related hard works and the perseverance which is made by the farmers and the other workers to create or to weave the fabric. So worth of a fabric, what do you mean by worth and a fabric? The worth means cost and fabric means the raw materials which are required to make clothes. Fabric is a cloth itself, and for making a cloth we require cotton. So this is, in this picture you can see that there is a saint and two people. The saint, as you can see, you can think about that it is a purchaser. Saint is a purchaser and the two men are the seller, but it is not the condition. Let's read about the chapter. So Thiruvalluvar was a great Tamil saint poet who lived more than 2000 years ago. Thirukural is the book of his teachings. It is greatly loved and respected even today. So here Tamil saint poet name was Thiruvalluvar, and Thirukular is the book of his teachings, the name of his book of his teachings. Okay, now he is loved and respected even today. He is known for his teachings. Now Thiruvalluvar was a textile weaver. Now what do you mean by a textile weaver? Textile weaver means what? The one who weave the clothes. One who weave the clothes. Weave, it means stitches clothes, make the clothes in a design manner. You mean that design manner means what? Stitching the clothes, stitching the designs into the clothes. Now he wore beautiful fabrics and saris and sold them in the market. People said that he never got angry, never used bad words, never shouted at anyone. It means fabrics and saris are both are the one and the same thing, like clothes. But fabrics means what? Different materials used to make clothes. Weave clothes. Fabric is in the sense clothes itself, but clothes in a design manner in which includes embroidery and designs is called as fabric. Now you can describe the saint into the manner like he was a saint poet which was silent and peace-minded person. Peace-minded person means what? He had never used any bad words, never shouted at anyone who came to him for purchasing any of the clothes from him. Now in the same town there lived a rich young man. He wasted most of his time roaming around with his friends. They often made fun of other people. "I don't believe what people say about his Valluvar," said the young man one day. "I'm sure I can make him angry. Come on, let's have some fun today." Now you can think about who is Valluvar. Above it is written as Thiruvalluvar, now it is written as Valluvar. It means what? Thiruvalluvar, but the rich young man say him as Valluvar. So Valluvar was the saint poet itself. Now so the arrogant young man approached Thiruvalluvar in the market and picked up a beautiful piece of fabric. Arrogant young man means what? Very angry person, very attitudeable person approached Thiruvalluvar, the saint poet, in the market and picked up a beautiful piece. It means what? They went to the poet and picked a piece of fabric, picked the clothes from his bunch of clothes, and then asked about what does this cost. What does this cost means what? Iska price kya? What is the price of these cloth? So now you can arrange this picture as in a very identified manner, that the saint which is sitting is a seller, and the two persons which I said earlier that they were sellers, but after understanding the lesson they were the rich young man who came to purchase the cloths, not to purchase the cloths but to make a fun of the saint. Now when the two persons asked the saint about the piece of a cloth cost, he said 4 coins very politely without any angry words. Then the youth was taken aback. Why doesn't the man get angry? He think about why does the man get angry even I have torn the clothes. Now he then tore the half pieces into half again. After making the half pieces, after making 50%, he made it into 25%. Now Again, he asked, how much this cost? 25%. Now he said, 2 coins was the answer. Now it was the young man who became impatient and agitated. He tore the pieces into half again and again, saying, and now what's the price now? So in this paragraph, you can understand that the person, that the two rich men came to make the Thiruvalluvar impatient and agitated, and to make fun of him, they became itself impatient and agitated while making him angry. Now Thiruvalluvar calmly went on reducing the price to half every time. As and when the two rich young persons make half of the pieces and torn it again and again, the Thiruvalluvar calmly reduces the price. Reduces means decrease the price into the half and half of the clothes. Now at last the fabric was reduced to rags. What do you mean by rag? Here, rag means what? Small pieces of the cloth. The cloth has become into very small pieces, like it was has been become ragged. Ragged means rag, because you know, rag pickers means what? The small pieces which a person collects, they are known as rag pickers. So here the cloth has been become into rag. Now Thiruvalluvar said on a quiet tone, now this fabric has become worthless. I will not become any price for this rags. So he said politely that there is no price for this rag now. As and when the rich and young person asked for the price, when the clothes became the rags, he also asked about what does this cost. But the Thiruvalluvar said that now this is worthless, because do you know, the fabric was not made in a day. That many people have toiled to make it. The farmer who grew cotton in his field worked hard for months through sun and rain. He picked cotton from each ball and gave it for spinning. Then someone else carded the cotton and spun it into long uniform threads. The threads were dyed carefully so that they took on these lovely colors. My wife could have and I wove the threads together, putting in beautiful designs. We thought someday someone will like this fabric, will be happy to be, all our work would have been done. So in the sense, whatever the meanings I have written, I will not explain those, but I will explain the meaning of the paragraph. That is, he said about the hard work and perseverance made by the farmers and the other workers who wove that cloth and who made the cotton into a cloth. In a sense, when the cotton was picked from the farm, it was a farmer's hard work and it was a farmer's work, whereas in the case weaving the cloth, it was the work of the saint and his wife. Now then all our work would have been rewarded. When you destroyed the fabric, you destroyed all the love and labor that went into his making. Many cannot bring back. So in this last 2 to 3 lines about the next para, is saying about that emotions or hard works cannot be brought about with the help of money. Balance through money, in the sense, with the help of money, we cannot make it anyone happy. Now the softly spoken words touched the young man's heart. So now he was really ashamed of himself. Now what do you mean by ashamed? Ashamed means feeling guilty, feeling very shy of that I made this things. And now the last paragraph is about, and do you know, Thiruvalluvar went to say, I can weave another fabric, but our life is also like this fabric. If you tear it apart with hasty and thoughtless actions, it will be destroyed and you will not get it back again. Hasty means unfriendly or wrong manner. And thoughtless actions means one without thinking anything, we torn that things, all the cloths, all our life or a part of life. Destroyed means spoiled. Everything is destroyed. Everything sets back. Now Thiruvalluvar words opened the young man's eyes, there and then decided to give up idleness and bad habits. And what do you mean by idleness? Here idleness means foolishness to sit idle. It means the one person who is not having any work sits idle, because he has very much money, very much amount of money to get all the things in his hand without any work or the perseverance. Now the question can come about, describe the saint poet and describe the rich young men. When the rich young men came, what did they said? What is the meaning of the words they said? What did saint reply to them and all? So please like, subscribe and share.